Welcome to our physical science class, Matter Around Us, Part 3.
Children, today we are going to discuss about diffusion. Diffusion, the particles of matter move continuously in liquids and gases. This movement is called diffusion. Diffusion is a net movement of anything from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration. Diffusion is driven by a gradient. It is an important process occurring in all living beings. Diffusion helps in the movement of substances in and out of the matter. Example, incense stick, smoke, vapor of scent, deodorant, etc. If you spray a perfume or a deodorant in one corner of the room, it spreads soon in all directions. Children, let's go to the activity 5. Observing the diffusion of liquids. Diffusion of potassium permanganate in water. Take two 250 ml beakers and fill them with water. Use a dropper and put a drop of blue or red ink or KMnO4 solution. Here KMnO4 means potassium permanganate. Slowly along the slides of the first beaker, we can observe that liquids also diffuse into each other like gases. Activity 6. Observing the diffusion of particles of solids into liquids. Take a beaker with full of water. Add a small potassium permanganate crystals to it. We observe that the diffusion of potassium permanganate crystals into water and the color of water changes. Repeat the experiment with copper sulfate crystals. Here also we observe the diffusion of copper sulfide, that means CuSO4 crystals, into water and the color of water changes. From the above observations, we found that the particles of solids diffuses into liquid. Children, let's go to do the lab activity, that is diffusion of two gases. The aim of the lab activity is to observe the speed of diffusion of two gases. Required materials are long glass tube with scale, liquid ammonia, hydrochloric acid, pieces of cotton, two rubber cords and pair of tongs. Take 1 meter along narrow glass tube. Take 2 pieces of cotton. Soak one in hydrochloric acid solution and another in ammonia solution. Insert them separately at the two ends of the tube with the help of the tongs. At the same time, close the ends of the glass tube with rubber cork and observe. The hydrochloric acid gives off hydrogen chloride gas and ammonia solution gives off ammonia gas. Both gases react together to form a white fumes of ammonium chloride. Observe the white ring in the tube due to formation of ammonium chloride. Children, how did the two gases travel along the tube? Which gas traveled faster? Observations. Both gases are react together to form a white precipitate called ammonium chloride. Conclusion. We can conclude that the ammonia gas traveled faster so that the distance of white precipitate is more from ammonia end than hydrochloric acid end. Activity 7. How small are the particles of matter? Take a beaker with water. Mark the level of water. Add 1 or 2 crystals of potassium permanganate and dissolve it in water. Color of water changes to light violet. Now, take out approximately 10 ml of this solution and it to 90 ml of clear water in another beaker. Now, the color of water will be lightened than in previous. Again, take out 10 ml of this solution and add to another 90 ml of water. Carry out this process 4 to 5 times and observe the changes in color of the solution. Observations. We observe that the water in last beaker also changed to light violet. From the above activity, we conclude that both solids and liquids are made up of tiny particles. Children, the next activity is 8. That is, there exists space between the particles. Observe this picture, children. Here, 3 beakers are there. Take these 3 beakers filled with water and mark the level of water. Add some salt and stir it thoroughly with a glass rod. Observe if there is any change in the water level. Add some more salt and stir it again. Observe it, the changes in the level of water. What you are observing? Does the level of water change? Or where did the salt go? Can you see it in the water? What your observations? From this activity, we observe that both solids and liquid particles have some space between them. We can conclude that the solid particles enter into the space between the liquid particles on dissolving solid in liquid. So, there is no change in the water level. Observing the force of attraction between the particles of matter. Open a water tap and allow the water to reach the ground. Now try to break the stream of water with our finger. But we cannot break the stream permanently. We cannot also break a piece of iron nail with our hands. But we cannot break the piece of chalk with our hands. What is our observations? From the above activity, we can say that particles of matter have force acting between them that keeps the particles together. It is also clear that this force is not equally strong in all the forms of matter. Children, this is the tabular form of properties of matter. Properties are shape, volume, compressibility and diffusion. Solids have fixed shape, fixed volume, very less compressibility and minimum diffusion. Then liquids have shape of the container, fixed volume, intermediate compressibility and intermediate diffusion. And then gases. Gases have no shape, no fixed volume, maximum compressibility and maximum diffusion. Thanks to everyone.